Life is short. Live in the moment. Our moment of life is brief. The world is unpredictable, but we can control ourselves. Practice for misfortune. Rehearse worst-case scenarios. Choose not to feel harmed and you won't feel harmed. Meditate on your own mortality. Keep a journal. Remember how small you are. Everything is ephemeral. Take the view from above. Don't try and control things that are out of your control. Stoicism, in popular usage, conjures images of bleak boarding schools, boys with stiff upper lips having cold baths every morning and never crying, before embarking on a lifetime of emotional repression, missing nanny and being physiologically unable to say "I love you" to their wives or children. But that cliché is a Spartan image and seems unfair to the original Stoics, whose ancient philosophy is supremely practical and applicable to modern life. To practice negative visualization, for example, is sound advice. Imagining and rehearsing the deaths of the people and animals close to you can be helpful in coping with these events when they eventually happen. Stoics prepare themselves. Take the view from above. This exercise in Stoicism is simple but clever. If you literally imagine looking down on the world from above, from a great height, so that you can see all the people, all the families, the farms, the feuds, the weddings and divorces, the births and the deaths, everything becomes more manageable, more normal, a shared experience. Everything that happens to us has almost certainly happened to someone else. We are tiny. Our cliff is in crumbling country at the end of a crumbling country. Long-term maps of rising sea levels show predicted future shape of Britain, with most of Norfolk and Suffolk under the sea. The wash will spread over several counties. Coastal erosion will continue past the 100-year line, past the 200-year line. But eventually, the erosion of the crumbling country will come up against the hard country, the stone, the Pennines, the Welsh mountains and castles, the fells, the highlands, Applecross, Arkell and Foynavon. Foynavon, with an O being the Grand National horse.